Hello students, today's video is for class 8 and we will start with a new poem, that is All the World's a Stage by William Shakespeare. Now, we all know who William Shakespeare is. He is one of the most famous playwrights, has written various poems. So basically know something about Shakespeare and what he has written. There are various plays, various poems, and those poems and plays mostly surround around one thing, that is love. Usually that's one of the topic that is being seen in the writings of the work of William Shakespeare. Now, All the World's a Stage is an excerpt taken from Shakespeare's play As You Like It. So now that we studied as a poem, originally it is not a poem, it is taken from the play As You Like It by William Shakespeare. It is a monologue by James, a character in Act 2 of the play. Now, monologue is basically when a person or a character says something to himself. Okay? So that's a monologue. So it's a monologue by Jake, so the characters in As You Like It. Jake sees the world as a temporary stage where all of mankind play a particular role in certain stages of life. So basically, the entire poem, as we learn it, is about the seven stages of life that Shakespeare is describing in his own words. It is often quoted as a standalone poem, full of meaning and describes the stark reality of men's existence in the various stages of his life. So Shakespeare here is basically trying to express the different stages of life that a man goes through and how it varies from one stage to the other and what are the difficulties that one faces in each stage. Yeah. So, in stage 1, as the picture shows, there's an infant. In stage 2, it's a small boy who is going to school with a backpack on his shoulder. In stage 3, we see that the boy is making friendship with a girl or anyone else for that matter. Okay, so that's the stage, youth. Stage 4, it is shown as a soldier. Stage 5, he is shown as a judge. In stage 6, he is shown as a person who is growing old. In the last stage, he is shown as someone who is going back into his childhood, where he doesn't have control over his emotions or senses for that matter. Now, before we go into the poem, let us just look at the background of this poem. All the World's a Stage is a poem written by William Shakespeare. In fact, like I told you, it is not a poem. It is a monologue from As You Like It, said by James. As the speech begins, seven different stages of a man's life are all that can come into your mind. So basically, here, even I would suggest, just like the poem says, when you are reading through the poem, try to visualize the seven stages that the poem is talking about, or the writer, William Shakespeare, is telling us. Each and every word is so beautifully written that you can actually imagine everything that is written, just like a movie running in front of your eyes. The seven stages of man's life also refers to the seven ages of man. These ages are infant, young, a school-going boy, a lover or a husband, a soldier or a fighter, a justice or a judge who has the ability to make proper judgments. And then we have the next stage where the person is turning old, and the last stage where he is going back to his childhood, that is old age. In this poem, Shakespeare has compared his life with a stage. He has used different words to beautify the poem in a wonderful way. He has taken this concept from medieval philosophy, which showed glimpses of several different groups as the seven deadly sins for theological reasons. Theology is a study of God's nature as well as religious beliefs. Now let's move on to the poem and understand what the poet or the playwright William Shakespeare is trying to tell us through Jakes and his monologue, which we are studying as a poem. Students, before we start with the poem, I would say open your book and pick the poem in front of you and follow as I explain each stage. Here, all the world's a stage and all the men and women merely peers. They have their exits and their entrances. And one man in his time plays many parts. Okay? These are the lines from which the monologue begins. Says all the world's a stage. The world that we are surrounded by, or the world that we are in, is basically like a stage where each man and woman are playing their own role. We all are assigned a different role. I am assigned the role of a teacher. You are assigned the role of a student. So we are basically playing our own roles. When I go back home, I be a daughter to my parents, sibling to my siblings. Alright, so basically what we are doing is we are playing our own roles, just like you play your role as a student and at home you are your child to your parents. Each and every individual are playing their own role. They have their exits and their entrances. Each one of us have our exits and entrances for each role. You are not going to be a student for all 24 hours. You are going to be a student only when you are in school. But when you go back home, you shift your character from a student being a child to your parents. And one man in his time plays many parts. So like I told you, each one of us has many parts to play. I might be playing a role of a teacher, a sister, a daughter. You might be playing a role of a student, a brother, a sister, a child. So yeah. In the next line, he says, his acts being seven ages. At first, the infant, merely incubating in the nurse's arm. So, the first stage begins here as an infant. Alright? The infant is merely incubating in the nurse's arm. Mewling is basically, you know, crying. A child cries, a small child, infant who doesn't know anything that's happening around, doesn't have control over his emotions or control over what or how he or she is behaving. He only cries according to his needs, or he'll smile, he'll laugh. Okay, he says, an infant mewling and puking in the nurse's arms is the first stage of human's seven stages. Then the whining schoolboy with a sashen and shining morning face, creeping like snail, unwilling to school. Okay, then the second stage is of an infant. Sorry, is of a schoolboy who is with a bag on his shoulder and a shining morning face, looking very fresh but creeping like a snail, unwilling to go to school. He doesn't want to go to school, very stubborn. He says he doesn't want to go to school, he wants to enjoy, play rather. Okay, that's the life of a schoolboy boy. Then, the lover, sang like ferns, with the woeful ballad made to his mistress Simon. Okay, then the stage of a lover. A lover who sees so much of emotions in the mistress's eye. He adores the beauty of the mistress. So he is full of emotions. He knows what love is. He knows how to express his love. Alright, he has a lot of passion. The word furnace is significant here to denote the feelings of passionate love. Then a soldier, full of strange oaths and bearded like a bard, jealous of honor, sudden and quick inquiry, seeking the bubble reputation, even in the cannon's mouth. Alright, then the next stage of a soldier who is not thinking even for a second. He is so much powerful, so much energetic that he is ready to fight. The next stage is that of a soldier who regards his oath to his state with his life, is proud of his honor and quick in battle. And then the justice. In fair Ram belly with good cavern line, with eyes severe and beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances, and so he plays his part. And the next stage is that of a powerful judge or justice. The Ram belly signifies that he is in a comfortable state of life, financially, and now knows the ins and outs of his trades. Okay, so he is in a stage where he is quite comfortable in what he is doing. He knows what is good and what is bad. He understands what is what it means to be wise. So he knows what decision he makes. Therefore, it is called a stage where he becomes a justice or a judge. The sixth age shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon, with spectacles and nose and pouch inside. He is youthful horse, well slaved, a world too wide for his time and his big manly voice. Turning age towards childish children, pipes and whistles in his sound. And the next stage, or the sixth age, is that of the old age and an age where everyone gets weakened. Our figures become lean, eyesight is weakened, and the old man has, as if, you know, turned to a feeble child once again. Okay? So there is a change in the physical appearance of a man. There's a change in his speech. It looks like he's turning back to his childhood. He is growing. Lasting of all, that ends this strange event from history, is second childness, or second childishness, and mere oblivion, sans teeth, sans eyes, and sans teeth, sans everything. Okay? The last stage of all is where a man is so weak, it looks like it is his second childishness. He is more of a stubborn child who has lost his control on his senses. He has lost everything. He's lost his teeth. He's lost his eyesight. He's lost his control on taste. He's lost his taste buds. He's lost everything. All the senses that are there in his body. Okay. So students, this is basically the seven stages that the poet, in a way of a monologue through James, is trying to tell us, where each stage is different from the other, and in each stage man has his own role to play. He plays his own role and it has significance. So this was about the poem by William Shakespeare. Now if you notice, students, there is only one thing that the poet is talking about here, or the entire poem is revolved around one single theme, that is life, or stages of life, that is very evidently discussed by the poet to us. Students, I hope you understood this poem. Please go through the poem, read it once again, and try to understand, try to picturize all the seven stages that the playwright is trying to put before us. The playwright, William Shakespeare himself, wants us to picturize this like a movie that is going on, like a movie, a play that is shifting from one stage to another. And with this, we come to the end of this poem. Thank you very much.